As opposed to abruptly cutting between two different states, we can add transitions, which animate these values over a set duration. Here are some thumbnails. They're for blog content. If we hover over them now, nothing happens. Actually, that's not true. We get our normal element blue highlighting effect, but we can turn that off right over here. But we can see that hovering does virtually nothing. That's because we haven't made any changes to our states. Let's select one of these and go over to states, and then hover. For right now, we'll make a change to the background color. If we hover, the background color change behaves as expected, but it cuts abruptly. If we go into states and switch back to none, we can scroll down and add a transition. In the dropdown, of course, we'll select background color. And with the default duration, 200 milliseconds, it fades smoothly. We can also change this number. Let's do 500 milliseconds. Hover again, and the transition takes place over 500 milliseconds. We can also go in and change the curve type, the easing curve, from the easing editor. Let's move forward with another example. This time, let's do the same thing with font color. We'll go to states, and then to hover, and we'll change our font color to get it just right. As expected, we have an abrupt cut on hover. Let's go back over to our none state, which is odd because it's not really a state, like hover or Wyoming. From none, we can go down and add a transition. This time, we'll select from our dropdown font color. Let's switch to 2000 milliseconds, or 2 seconds. And on hover, we have a smooth, albeit kind of slow, transition. Finally, let's play with shadows. Over here, we can add a subtle shadow. We can go in and make changes to these values so everything looks just how we want it to look before we cover the hover and transition. And when we're done, let's go over to our hover state. If we increase the intensity of our shadow, or even the distance, that hover cut, that abrupt transition or lack of transition, is obvious. By now, you probably know what we're going to do. Now, we can see here that the transition area is grayed out. Why? Because we're styling in the hover state. As we know, we have to switch back to none to add a transition. And when we do, we can add a transition. This time we'll select box shadow from our dropdown, and we'll switch to 500 milliseconds. If we demo that, we can see the shadow intensity and its distance transition smoothly. There's so much more you can do with transitions. Keep in mind, it'll transition style changes between hover and pressed as well, using those same transition values. But that's how to add and configure transitions between a class's states.